Hello students, welcome to the lecture on barriers to communication. And after this lecture, we will be able to learn the following objectives. Describe the concept of barriers to communication. Explain the nature of barriers. Describe the space-time-distance barriers. Explain the gender barriers. Overcome the barriers of communication. Describe how to achieve effective communication. Let's start with an introduction to the barriers of communication. Communication plays a most important role in an employer-employee relationships on farm operations. It also affects the relationships among family members on the management team. Although effective communication does not guarantee success of a farm operation, its absence usually assures problems. A communication problem may soon become a disaster, or it may linger on for years. No matter how good the communication systems in an operation are, communications barriers can and do often occur. This may be caused by a number of reasons that can usually be summarized as being due to physical barriers, system design faults, or additional barriers. Physical barriers are often due to the nature of the environment. One natural barrier is when managers and employees are located in different buildings or on different sites of the operation. Likewise, poor or outdated equipment, particularly the failure of management to introduce new technology, may also cause problems. Let us now discuss the concept of barriers to communication. Communication plays a major role in developing a relationship. It can also affect the relationship among family members or management in an institute. More specifically, communication influences the effectiveness of instruction, performance evaluation, and the handling of discipline problems. Communication should be straightforward. A barrier to communication is something that keeps meanings from meeting. Meaning barriers exist between all people, making communication much more difficult than most people seem to realize. It is false to assume that if one can talk, he can communicate. Because so much of our education misleads people into thinking that communication is easier than it is, they become discouraged and give up when they run into difficulty. Types of barriers. Most people would agree that communication between two individuals should be simple. It is important to remember that there are differences between talking and communicating. When you communicate, you are successful in getting your point across to the person you are talking to. When we talk, we tend to erect barriers that hinder our ability to communicate. There are 7 of these types of barriers to effective communication. Physical barriers. These are easy to spot. Doors that are closed, walls that are erected, and distance between people all work against the goal of effective communication. Perceptual barriers. These barriers, in contrast, are internal. If you go into a situation thinking that the person you are talking to is not going to understand or be interested in what you have to say, you may end up subconsciously sabotaging your effort to make your point. Emotional barriers. These can be tough to overcome, but are important to put aside to engage in conversations. We are often taught to fear the words coming out from our own mouths, as in the phrase, anything you say can and will be used against you. Cultural barriers. These are a result of living in an ever-shrinking world. Language barriers. These seem pretty self-inherent, but there are often hidden language barriers that we are not always aware of. Gender barriers. These have become less of an issue in recent years, but there is still the possibility for a man to misconstrue the words of a woman, or vice versa. Interpersonal barriers. These are what ultimately keep us from reaching out to each other and opening ourselves up, not just to be heard, but to hear others. Miscommunication. Miscommunication is a general term that denotes all kinds of problems that may occur in dialogue. People usually try to complete tasks with the least effort that will produce a satisfactory solution. In task-oriented dialogue, this produces a tension between conveying information carefully to the partner and leaving it to be inferred, risking a misunderstanding, and the need for recovery. There are different ways of analyzing miscommunication phenomena. A common distinction is made between misunderstanding and non-understanding. Misunderstanding means that the listener obtains an interpretation that is not in line with the speaker's intentions. Noise. Noise refers to the distraction and interference in the environment in which communication takes place. This affects the accuracy, clarity, or even the arrival of the message. Noise can be further classified into 4 different types. 1. Physical noise. 2. Technical noise. 3. Social noise. And 4. Psychological noise. 1. Physical noise. Obstruction caused by environmental factors is termed as physical noise. 2. Technical noise. This noise involves the failure of the medium of communication. 3. Social noise. It is the interference caused by differences in personality and cultures of the members communicating. 4. Psychological noise. It includes excessive such as emotion, prejudice, nervousness, etc. Overcoming measures. Overcoming the communication barriers requires a vigilant observation and thoughts of potential barriers in a particular instance of communication. State all the anticipated barriers that may have impact on your day-to-day communication. Strategies to overcome barriers will be different in different situations, depending upon the type of barriers present. Eliminating differences in perception. The organization should ensure that it is recruiting right individuals on the job. Eliminating differences in perception. The organization should ensure that it is recruiting right individuals on the job. Use of simple language. Use of simple and clear words should be emphasized. Use of ambiguous words and jargons should be avoided. Reduction and elimination of noise levels. Noise is the main communication barrier which must be overcome on a priority basis. Now we will study the nature of barriers. A barrier is a block that prevents a meeting of meaning between two or more people. In the case of preaching, the barriers are usually between the preacher and his consciously organized effort to communicate a message, and the individual persons who make up his congregation. As we have already pointed out, there's a movement of meaning from each side, but the arrows moving in the opposite direction indicate that meanings often do not meet and return without receiving response. It is as if the meanings hit something between the communicators that caused them to bounce back. Sharing the problem. They could help each other by at least sharing the problem. The church's preachers and teachers, for the most part, seem to ignore the processes of interaction and learning. Verbal communication barriers. Verbal communication is an important part of life. People rely upon verbal communication in their interaction with families, co-workers, and peers. However, verbal communication can occasionally break down or be impeded by barriers. Nonverbal communication barriers. Nonverbal communication is just as important, if not more so, than verbal communication. The way you sit or stand, the tone of your voice, and your general physical behavior are all manners of communication. Paralanguage. Paralanguage is the way inflections are used when sending a message verbally. Silence. Silence can be used as a threatening tool to ignore and disregard another person's need for communication. Body language. Body language can create a communication barrier. A person with their head down, folded arms, or turning their back to you are all examples of body language that creates a wall from communicating. Facial expression. A person's facial expression can act as a barrier, especially when there is insecurity or fear involved in the conversation. Facial expressions can be misinterpreted and misunderstood. Paraverbal communication barriers. Paraverbal communication refers to the way you say something. It includes your tone, emphasis, and pacing. Paraverbal communication indicates your emotions about the message and can change the meaning of your words. Barriers of inconsistency. Inconsistency is the uncomfortable feeling caused by holding conflicting ideas simultaneously. Listening barriers. Listening may not seem like a mystical or complicated process. Someone speaks and you listen. As you receive the information being communicated, you are likely not realizing that you decode the dialogue, interpreting it according to your own known information and set of beliefs so it makes sense to you. Types of listening barriers. Listening is not just about hearing a message. Listening requires people to pay attention to a message and process the information it conveys. Attention span. An attention span is the amount of time a person will pay attention to a message before getting distracted. Noise. Noise is a barrier that prevents people from listening to messages. Barriers at communication process. Communication can be defined as the process of transmitting information and common understanding from one person to another. The word communication is derived from the Latin word communism, which means common. The definition underscores the fact that unless a common understanding results from the exchange of information, there is no communication. Decoding barriers. The communication cycle may break down at the receiving end for some of these reasons. Lack of interest. If a message reaches a reader who is not interested in the message, the reader may read the message hurriedly or listen to the message carelessly. Miscommunication may result in both cases. Lack of knowledge. If a receiver is unable to understand a message filled with technical information, communication will break down. Emotional distractions. If emotions interfere with the creation and transmission of a message, they can also disrupt reception. General barriers to communication. There are various general barriers to communication. Background noise. The background noise is a major impact on the potential barriers of effective communication. Distractions. The distractions can be a major impact on the potential barriers. Cultural difference. The cultural difference has major impact with potential barriers to communication. Semantic barriers. Semantic refer to the systematic study of the meaning of the words and signs. Simplicity, clarity, and brevity reduce semantic barriers of communication. Let's know about space-time-distance barriers. It is evident that physical distance requires special communication tools to make communication happen. The same is required within distance in time. Distance in time poses more difficulties as we can communicate only in real time and forward in time. That is evident that we cannot do it back in time. The fact that we can communicate forward in time and that we do not want unnecessary communication encourage us to create different structures, which process, filter, and eliminate sent information. The question whether they are effective is a separate question. It seems that mostly not. To overcome listening barriers. Listening is a vital aspect of effective communication. Listening is a receptive skill in oral mode of a communication. Listening means that what we hear, we also understand that thing. Excessive talking. If you insist on monopolizing the conversation, you are not going to hear very much. People hesitate to communicate to those who talk excessively and do not listen to others. Prejudice. Prejudice is a preconceived opinion of feeling, which is usually against the speaker. To overcome perception-related barriers. Effective communication is not only exchange of words or expressions or thoughts, but also a place where the perceptions meet. To overcome verbal communication barriers. Lacking clarity. Avoid abstract, overly formal language, colloquialisms, and jargon which obscure your message more than they serve to impress people. Using stereotypes and generalizations. Jumping to conclusions. Dysfunctional responses. Lacking confidence. Facilitating communication. Facilitated communication is a technique by which a facilitator provides physical and other supports in an attempt to assist a person with a significant communication disability, to point to pictures, objects, printed letters and words, or to a keyboard. Gender barriers to communication arise because men and women have a different way of communication, and each feels uncomfortable while talking to the other, because of the basic differences in communication styles. For example, women on average speak about 25,000 words a day, while this number is around 7,000 for men. This shows that men are more precise while women like details, and when the two communicate, they will get bored. Secondly, the speaking function of the brain in men on the left side, but in women it is located in both left and right hemispheres of the brain. Stereotypes. Men and women have a history of being painted into a box of stereotypical personalities from childhood. Misunderstanding. Understanding the types of ways men and women contact others helps reduce the barricade of interaction between the sexes. Patience. Patience, or lack thereof, is a barrier to any type of communication. Communication barriers exist all around us. Misinterpretations abound with team members. We delete, distort, and generalize information in every conversation. And yet, we think we clearly understand what others are saying and why they are saying it. These barriers exist because we put them there. There are many ways we interpret information given to us by others, and these cause us to have a misalignment of understanding. How can we reduce the barriers that effectively blind us to meaning and comprehension? Here are 7 ways. Understand others see things differently to you. Try to predict the feelings and attitude of the receiver. What will their expectation be? What about their state of mind when you are communicating? What prejudices might they have? If you know these things before communicating, you reduce the risk of misinterpretation. Get feedback from the receiver. Do not just ask, "Do you understand?" They will more often than not say yes, because they see things in the way they want to understand it. Ask instead what their understanding of the message is and how they see it. As often as possible, speak face to face. This will allow for questions and, most importantly, allow you to see the body language, which will convey much more meaning than over the phone or through email. Use language that fits the audience. Do not try to impress by using language and words that may be distorted by the listener. It simply makes them confused and inadequate. Plus, they would not be listening to you while they try to work out what on earth you are on about. Use the right communication channel. Do not send an email if it is quicker to pick up the phone or go and talk to the person. Use email for its proper purpose. We are rapidly losing the art of conversation. Do not add to that by using the wrong channel. Have integrity and honesty in your communications. Make it easy for others to listen to you. Communicating with people effectively can help you succeed in all aspects of life. Every day you encounter new people and situations to which you must adapt. Exude confidence. Feeling good about yourself and knowing you are worthy of other people's time allows you to have more meaningful conversations and take risks when it comes to talking about new and different things. Encourage others to tell you what is going on in their life. Begin with small talk to engage someone, but avoid sticking to mundane or general subjects, such as the weather or how's it going. Ask open-ended questions, such as what did you do this weekend or what do you like to do in your spare time. This gets the person thinking and makes him recognize you as a person with whom he can have a meaningful conversation. Listen more than you talk. Have a general knowledge and diversify yourself. Did you know? In 1960, David Berlow expanded on Shannon and Weaver's 1949 linear model of communication and created the SMCR model of communication. Now in the end, let us summarize what we have learned in this lecture. Communication plays a most important role in employer-employee relationships on farm operations. It also affects the relationships among family members on the management team. A barrier to communication is something that keeps meanings from meeting. Meaning barriers exist between all people, making communication much more difficult than most people seem to realize. People usually try to complete tasks with the least effort that will produce a satisfactory solution. In task-oriented dialogue, this produces a tension between conveying information carefully to the partner and leaving it to be inferred, risking a misunderstanding and the need for recovery. Noise refers to the distraction and interference in the environment in which communication takes place. This affects the accuracy, clarity, or even the arrival of the message. Verbal communication is an important part of life. People rely upon verbal communication in their interaction with families, co-workers, and peers. However, verbal communication can occasionally break down or be impeded by barriers.